So, one day, I was sitting at the airport, counting the cash I had just pickpocketed. No, not really, just checking whether you were paying attention. And I noticed a couple of planes parked side by side near the terminal. They looked almost the same, but one of them had a rounded nose, while the other one was pointed. Well, it got me to thinking, what's the difference? Who knows? Most commercial aircraft, for example, the mammoth Airbus A380, which can seat up to 868 passengers, or the somewhat smaller Boeing 747, have blunt noses. On the other hand, several models of passenger airliners have sharp noses. And all military airplanes have pointed noses. So, what gives? Let me get straight to the point. The manufacturers decide on the shape of a plane's nose depending on the speed at which it's going to travel. There are two types of planes: subsonic, meaning their speed is slower than the speed of sound, and supersonic, the ones that fly faster than you know what. Subsonic planes are equipped with a rounded nose. During the flight, it allows the air to move around the airplane more freely. In other words, when an airplane with a blunt nose pushes the air, it rolls over the fuselage without any serious resistance. Now, what would happen if a supersonic plane had a blunt nose? Well, imagine a machine that's flying at breakneck speed, to be precise, at a speed of more than 767 miles per hour, which is how fast sound travels. When the air first meets the rounded nose of a subsonic plane, it produces a shockwave. If you're not flying very fast, well, relatively, it doesn't matter. But at hypersonic speeds, the created shock would be too strong and could possibly lead to big problems, including serious damage to the fuselage. The solution turned out to be quite simple: to build supersonic aircraft with sharp, pointed noses. This way, the airplane manages to minimize the resistance caused by the shock after the speed of sound is reached. For example, just look at the famous Concorde plane, which stopped flying only in 2003. With its pointed nose, this supersonic passenger airliner could fly at a maximum speed of more than twice the speed of sound. However, there's another curious thing about supersonic jets. Not only do they need to have a pointed nose, but they also have to be made out of a super strong material. The faster a plane flies after passing the sound barrier, the hotter it becomes. That's why some of the fastest aircraft are made of titanium. This material doesn't deform or melt at the blistering speeds they reach. On the other hand, should a plane accelerate to the speed of a spacecraft, it would become so hot that even titanium wouldn't be able to hold up. So, how do spacecraft deal with this problem? By having blunt noses. I know, it may sound paradoxical, but in their case, the rounded nose helps them to create a bow-shaped shockwave after reaching supersonic speeds. This kind of shockwave also starts in the front of a spacecraft, but doesn't actually touch it. As a result, the material a spacecraft is made of doesn't heat up as much as it would with a pointed nose. At the same time, rounded noses have one serious drawback. The spacecraft equipped with them consume too much fuel, which costs a lot of money. That's why manufacturers only equip space shuttles with blunt noses if they absolutely have to. So, would you like to fly a supersonic jet with a pointed nose? Tell me your opinion in the comment section below. In any case, there's a chance that in several decades, it won't matter whether a plane has a pointed or a blunt nose, because aircraft might start to look totally different altogether. For example, according to one of the predictions, planes in the future might come without windows whatsoever. It'll supposedly make the fuselage stronger, which, in turn, will allow aircraft to fly at incredible speeds. Likewise, air travel is likely to become much greener by 2050, thanks to commercial airplanes becoming fully electric. It would cut down on harmful greenhouse gas emissions and save tons of money on fuel. Besides, electric planes would be much quieter than the ones flying today. Currently, the main goal is to create a battery that would be able to power an airplane throughout the whole flight. And at the same time, this battery shouldn't be insanely heavy or massive. Unfortunately, right now, manufacturers don't have the technology that would combine these two requirements. Also, in several decades, planes might lose their tails. Should airliners become electric, they could be equipped with a special system that would provide thrust in any needed direction, not only backwards like today. As a result, there wouldn't be any more need for additional control pieces, including the tail. Another change in the aircraft of the future may relate to the material they'd be made of. The problem is that the heavier the plane is, the more fuel it needs to fly, and the more expensive the flights are. That's why, at some point, you might witness aluminum planes turning into carbon fiber ones. One of the benefits of building planes from carbon fiber is the engineers would be able to extend the wings vertically, which would mean additional efficiency during the flight. Also, the plane's shell would be way tougher. This way, if a stray bird crashed into the airliner, it wouldn't even leave a small dent. There might also be some unusual-looking and oddly shaped aircraft. For example, the airplanes of the future might get a box wing design. Engineers claim that this idea would become reality thanks to super lightweight non-metallic materials that could be used during construction. The box wing design could make future planes' engines 5 times more effective than the ones used today. Another cool aircraft project is called the Sky Whale. This plane might easily become the largest passenger airliner ever. It would dwarf the biggest plane of our times, the Airbus A380-800, which typically seats 575 passengers. The Sky Whale would be able to transport 755 passengers at a time. It would have 3 passenger decks and several viewing platforms upstairs. Interestingly, even with such impressive characteristics, the future mammoth aircraft would use less fuel and produce significantly less noise. What's more, airport runways wouldn't have to be any longer. The plane's powerful engines would allow the machine to take off with more power. Anyway, experts say that while the construction of the Sky Whale isn't likely to start anytime soon, all the components necessary for building this giant can easily be manufactured. One more idea is a plane with massive wings, which would have the body built into them. Theoretically, this innovation is supposed to make the plane more aerodynamic. The engines of such a flying machine would be turboelectric. That's the most effective way to make them greener and to minimize the amount of noise they would produce. As for the shape of the plane, it might look more like a UFO or a triangle, which would reduce the drag during takeoff and save precious fuel. And now, how do you feel about the flying V aircraft? Admittedly, this machine doesn't look like anything you've ever seen before. On the other hand, such an unusual shape is supposed to make the plane super energy efficient. Also, the V-shaped aircraft would be able to travel ultra-long haul distances. The main peculiarity of this airliner is that the passenger cabin, fuel tanks, and cargo hold would be in the wings, which would give the plane an exciting form. At 180 feet long, the plane would seat 314 passengers. Sorry, no mention here about the leg room. And the best thing about the flying V? There would be no need to change the airport's infrastructure, for example, hangars, gates, or runways. This airliner wouldn't take up any more space. So, whether it's blunt or pointed, now you knows. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give this video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.